ultimately is as magnetic and exciting as he is repellent. There are aspects of his character which are very difficult to admire or even tolerate. He was childish. He was not on their businesses than many of the people who most admired him. But above and beyond that, Crowley was and is mythic. And there are aspects of his image which are very, very positive. I find it difficult not to stand in awe of his appetite for love, his vigour, his determination to challenge himself and the world around him. Crowley wasn't afraid of anything or anyone.
Very clever. Genius, for God's sake. Raving genius, you know. In a world of little tiny people, as Chloe said, my God, why are you so unhappy? You want to make love? Well, make love, for Christ's sake. You want to take drugs? You want to expand your consciousness? Please, do it.
Those golden, golden stars.
followers believe that he was a true prophet because he foresaw a society that has now embraced ideas of sexual and spiritual freedom. Others are not so sure.
I think today modern occultism sees a very watered-down version of Crowley. They gloss over some of the atrocious things that he did. And they just want to see him as a benign humanist, somebody who said, let's be free, let's go with the flow. And it is to deny an awful lot of evilness that happened in his practices. We should be open and honest about Aleister Crowley.
The Book of the Law states, do what thou wilt shall be the whole of the law. In other words, people have the right to determine exactly how to live their lives, regardless of moral and religious boundaries.
It's ripping up all the holy books and saying, we're starting fresh now. This is the word of the new eon. We're going to peck out the eyes of Christ on the cross. It's very, very blasphemous. It's all about liberation. It's all about having no restrictions at all. You follow your path, you follow your goal in life, and you do that above all else.